you very much for inviting me. It's brilliant being back here. And what did you go and build this thing after I left?
I persuaded you to come back, Jane.
Ah, clever you. Come on in, we just started. Well, it was lovely having Lynn this morning. I'm sure you thoroughly enjoyed that. And she told me yesterday morning what she's going to talk about. So some of the things that I had planned to say might just double up slightly on what she has said, but it won't do any harm because all of that was good meat for us. I'm talking about planning your year. Obviously, you'll only plan it to suit yourself, and as she said, you have to know what your reasons are for swimming, and if they're simply to get fit, you won't be doing the same sort of work as those folk who are going to New Zealand next year and hoping to do 200 metres butterfly and swim in the sea for 3K. So it's quite a wide spectrum that we probably have to cover today. I'd like to say, first of all, I'm sure that it all applies to you all, feeling good. It makes you feel better mentally, physically, emotionally. You just get out and you think, oh, I'm glad that came. Sometimes you think, oh God, end of the day, honestly, I'm tired. But someone says, see you there? Oh, right. And then when you've done it, you just go out there buzzing. We swim really late. We swim until after 10 o'clock at night. And some of our folk have started work at sort of 6 in the morning. And it's brilliant the fact that they turn out at all. And I'm sure that some of you are just the same. It's worth everything you put into it. But having started and got feeling better, then some of you think, well, now what next? And you have to fix some idea for yourselves. As Lynn said, you need goals. You need short-term goals. That might just be finish this session. It might be, might be just get to the bloody end. You need a mid-term goal, which is normally not that far ahead. But maybe a meet. It may be next year's meet. And then you need a long-term goal, which is usually just, well, I hope I can stay alive. And the longer you swim, the better you're going to feel till that day comes. I'm quite sure anyone who's done any other sport is going to feel the same way. You know, you play squash and you end up with a shoulder, and you run and you end up with a knee. But you get in the water and it's home. And you can just let it do the work. This is the thing I think everybody really does need to understand. Let the water do the work. If you look at a fish, he's got weeny little fins. And we've got a load more stuff to use if we know how to use it. So that's what I'm going to be doing in the pool this afternoon, trying to show you how not to work. Because efficiency is intelligent laziness. That's my catchphrase. Yourselves. I've been there, I know what it's like, and you have to take yourself in hand quite seriously. In that case, I think you must sit and do some hard thinking and write it down. When you commit your goals to paper, it's there in front of you. Like learning a language, you put those words up on the basin, or, you know, so you read those verbs every day. If you write for yourself, now I'm aiming to do the swimathon next March. You keep looking at it and you think, yeah, really? And then you think again, well, if I just start now, I'll build it up. And gradually, as the time goes by, you can bring yourself to be more positive about it. But you must put your steps in view. Something that you know you can do. Might have to stretch a bit to do it, but you can do it. Best way is to find a mate who'll come along and do it with you, of course. Get a bunch of people. And you don't even all have to be good. You can all have different standards and different aims, but you meet because afterwards you're going to have coffee or something else. I was at Stradbrook last night. We had a beer. That's a great bunch. But you may need to join a club because if they'll find space for you, you do drop into habits when you're on your own, and you can't see yourself, especially if you're a breaststroker. It's all happening back there, and you don't know. You do need someone every now and again. I still have friends who very kindly come up to me after I've done a breaststroke race, usually, and say, you know, you weren't finishing that kick. That's right. You think back then, I was thinking I was and I wasn't. And other people can see what you can't see, and that's why it is helpful to be where there is a coach. Now, I know a lot of mainstream clubs, they'll let you in for a while, and then gradually their kids build up and they haven't got space for you, and it's really very sad. And you might have to find another group of people, and there are people who set up their own clubs. Ta-da! But a little help goes a long way, even if you're only helping each other. Reading is very helpful, and Giovanna was saying, she takes this, I swear by this, if you're a competitive triathlete, peak performance covers running, cycling, and swimming. There's less swimming than anything else, but anything they say can be adjusted, and I use it a lot for my schedules. There's new ideas, there's enthusiasm, there's knowledge, it's great. There are other magazines that are available. There's a few American magazines. This one is specifically for master swimmers. And I enjoy this one. Some of it's a bit American. It has to be. But you get pictures like Gary Hall. But a lot of it is jolly interesting. They don't put much about us in it, and that's a bit of a shame. But we still... It's good. Swimming Times does a bit on us, but the new one, Watermarks, which I haven't got, that's awful. But Watermarks is specially for English master swimmers, and it has got results, it's got what else you can swim in, and it's got some excellent articles. They cover all the different strokes, big articles. It's really a very good magazine to take. So, doing some reading is a great help. And it also helps you to change your ideas, because quite often, if you've been swimming for years, and there's a lot of people who get in, we used to see them at St. Augustine's, and I guess you have them here, who'll get in and they'll swim for half an hour, or they'll swim for an hour, and that's their thing. Those of us who've done other sorts of swimming, we couldn't do that, just swim for an hour, unless there was a jolly good coffee at the end. But what you need to do is to plan something that interests yourself. Put in some things that are not going to be easy, because you have to have a stretch. And then put in some things that are much more to your taste, but think what you're doing while you do it. Now what I have said is plan it. Try to put something down on paper, even if it is just swim for half an hour, and then change and do something else for 10 minutes, and then finish with something else. When you put it on paper, then you'll think, oh, well, I could improve on that. Because if you just get in the water and you swim, you think, oh, no, this. I'll just do a bit on my back. I'm like, oh, yeah, it's 1:45. Well, I'll get out now. It's too easy to do. You write it down, and then you've committed yourself. So those are just the sort of guidelines. Now, I divide my year up because I plan for different things at different times of the year. You have a picture a bit like this. Well, the true artist can draw a perfect circle. I ain't too good at this. How about that? It's a bit of an egg, but anyway. So, this is your year. I'll do a roll Paris here. So here's January. You have that. You've just had Christmas. Oh. So you haven't been swimming, you haven't been doing very much at all, except eat, and you feel horrible. So here you have to be nice to yourself, and just get in, and have a little float about, and gradually you'll feel a little bit better, especially if you're thinking, now, for us, February means we go to the Isle of Wight. Now, anyone here been to the Isle of Wight, meet? Yeah, it's lovely, isn't it? It's springtime. They're a little ahead of us. It's not, you don't have to fly. You drive down there and you just go across a little bit of sea and you feel as if you're abroad. That's really nice. They've got some very good events. If you are a distance swimmer and you don't like sprinting, they've got an 800 metre freestyle. And you can just go and do that, and you can go and have your beer. Or, you know, whatever. But that sets you up. Then we have March. Now you're feeling much better, and you're beginning to think, well, I could do. Where's Sudbury? Somewhere in there.
I think next weekend is, next year, I think it's the same weekend of the Isle
of Wight. Well, then you're going to have to toss a coin. But for several of us, this is really. That's the really big one. That's Guernsey. Who's been to Guernsey then? Hey!
That's
changes.
Now, of course, this year it is going to be different, but I'm just talking about the normal year. It will be in May because we've got the New Zealand thing. But now, Guernsey, it starts, you need to go over on Thursday because you've got to breathe that fresh air first. And you go walkies by the sea. They swim Friday night. And they also have the whole range, the right 200 fly. Don't have a 400 ready, but they have a 200 ready. There's plenty to choose from. And there's also some very good eating. It's a great place. So if you want a little holiday, that is a super spot. That's at the end of March usually. Well, I've been around April here. Otherwise I'll forget where I am. Now normally Leamington is somewhere about there. That's the Midland District. And again, that's a nice little holiday. Who goes to Leamington? Yeah. Really a lovely meet. And there's a pretty good, it's a pretty good competition there because it's into the Midlands. It's very well run. And sometimes if you get a world record, they give you a bottle of champagne. That's really something. But you find people there who really are good. And you go there and you expect to see some good swimming. And you see what you're looking for. It's terrific. Then we have May. Maybe here is the GB Championships. Now, if it's possible, it's quite an interesting outing to see that because foreigners are allowed to come. That is long course. 50 metre pools. We've got Germans, we've got Swiss, the French come over, we have the Dutch, and you see a different view. And the 50 metre pool looks like forever when you first do it. But you do adjust it, and it is an interesting experience. Well, you know it because you've got this here. And Crystal Palace isn't a touch on this, I must say. Maybe you won't want to go. But you it's worth the effort. And it's worth having to travel somewhere because you find out something different, having to sit in a car or whatever and then get up and get out there. And quite often you don't swim your first race very well. All these things are educational. All these things are something that are worth learning. And even if you aren't intending to go any further than that, GB is Great Britain. It's a great thing to take part in that. And they don't have time cut-offs yet, so it's worth going to that and just having a try. There are some jolly old people who go there. So down we go to June. That depends. Norfolk Masters?
It was my end of my this year.
Yeah.
And Sussex.